had joy, we had fun, we had in the sun.
We interrupt this program to give you a bulletin just received from one of our naval units at sea. A large object traveling at supersonic speed is headed over the North Atlantic toward the east coast of the United States.
An unidentified object was picked up 200 miles southwest of Point Barrow, Alaska.
Shall we report it, sir?
What, that we're being invaded by little green men from outer space?
Flying saucers have invaded our planet.
It was a saucer. A flying saucer.
Brought to evidence, these creatures have scientific knowledge far in advance of our own.
We've come to this planet looking for intelligent life. Oops, we made a mistake.
Welcome once again to the podcast that showcases humans behaving badly. This is why the aliens don't come. My name is Brendan Millett, and with me is... I know we were going to have this gimmick where I have a different adjective for you every week, but I neglected to prepare one, so I'm just going to say my co-host, Michelle Poitras.
Hello.
You didn't take very well to the juicy adjective last week, so...
No, I thought it was fine. I just needed a minute to process it, really.
And maybe like, some clarification?
Yeah, a little bit.
Are you calling me fat, you know, or something?
A little, yeah.
Anyway, folks, thank you for listening. I know a lot of people have listened to our first two podcasts, and... we've got more of the same for you this week, including some listener-submitted stories that you are not gonna fucking believe, and some amazing stuff I found on some message boards, as you do on the interwebs.
Like you do.
Oh, God. Now we're just gonna say that to say it. Jesus.
Pretty much.
At least the first time it was organic. Now it's officially a catchphrase, I think.
I like it.
So, wanted to try something a little different this week to start things off. Michelle and I, you might say, we're pretty big geeks. We're not always necessarily geeky about the exact same things, but there's quite a bit of common ground as far as the stuff, you know, that overlaps, particularly movies. I mean, you and I speak so much in movie quotes, it's practically a language.
I mean, seriously, I was actually starting to get annoyed with myself last podcast because everything you said, I had a movie quote or movie reference for, and I was...
You know, now that you say that, you absolutely did.
And I was like, wow, I'm that person.
But like I said about the, the Kevin Bacon game that we played last week, you know, humans have this kind of technology, and this is the kind of dumb shit we do with it. We go online, look at porn, and bitch about movies. So we're going to try out a new segment this week called This Week in Geek.
The internet is a communications tool used the world over where people can come together to bitch about movies and share pornography with one another.
So probably the biggest geek news of this year is what will be hitting theaters in December of this year, and of course I'm talking about Star Wars The Force Awakens. Now, you and I pretty much grew up with Star Wars.
Uh-huh.
You're not a fan.
I am.
Not by the look on your face.
No, I am a Star Wars fan. I am. And I enjoy it. I like the movies. I don't understand the hardcore 24/7 obsession. I don't have that.
I'm not hardcore 100% obsessed with Star Wars, but I'm certainly a fan.
Mm-hmm.
You know,
no, I'm a fan.
Yeah, I mean, I didn't go to see, you know, Phantom Menace dressed as a Jedi or anything.
No.
And
yeah,
you
I
would know
that.
You were there. So.
Yes, I was.
I saw it with you.
I know.
Yeah, that was quite a day. My car broke down on the way to the 9 a.m. show. We ended up having to go that night.
That really should have been a sign, though.
It should have been a sign. Don't go see this movie. It's going to be complete and total bantha poodoo, you know?
Seriously, like, that was, like, that movie, was that movie Fanboys? Where they
oh, yeah, yeah. Oh,
in?
Yes.
That is a fantastic movie.
Yes.
In many ways.
I know where you're going.
But yeah, that one, like, what if it sucks?
Yeah, the very end of the movie, they're obsessed with seeing Phantom Menace, and then the very last shot, dude, what if it sucks? It was unbelievable. I think I laughed so hard. To tell you the truth, I thought Attack of the Clones sucked way worse.
Oh, way worse.
Way worse.
Way worse.
And Revenge of the Sith was much better. Still not great.
Still not great, but better.
But better. A lot more solid. But anyway, you know, of course, the trailer's been out for a while now, and it's coming out in December.
It was a dumb move, because now all everyone's doing is dissecting it endlessly.
Yeah, and see, that's the thing. I don't go that far with it. They're talking about, oh, the first shot's a stormtrooper, but it doesn't look like the clone guy from the prequels. I'm like, they recruited other guys. You know, I mean, you got to figure this is taking place, what, 60 years after the prequel trilogy? It stands to reason they lost a few.
Yeah.
You know, between fighting the rebellion and hunting down Jedi, you know, and they're going to take recruits.
Yeah, pretty much.
You know, and the one thing that everybody's bitching about is the guy we presume is going to be the Sith Lord, the villain in it. With the lightsaber that has, like, the two little lightsaber blades on the side that look like a sword guard.
Looks like a cross.
No, but it's supposed to be, like, a sword guard. And I'm going, why are you nitpicking about that? Some person finally figured out, after all these severed hands have been flying around for the last 30-plus years, put a guard on the sword!
Mm-hmm.
You know? God. But I gotta tell you, I thought the trailer looked pretty damn good, and it's in the hands...
I haven't even watched it.
It's in the hands of J.J. Abrams, who brought back Star Trek.
Which gives me hope, because yes. I am a way more diehard Trekkie fan.
That is true.
And I don't care about the Trekkers.
I'm more into Trek than Wars myself, yeah. But I am into both.
And I don't care about the Trekkie versus Trekker. I don't care.
No, fuck that.
I'm a Trekkie. I don't care. And yeah. So, but yeah, I'm way more into Trek than I am Star Wars. And oh my God, when I saw that first movie, that new movie in 2009, I was in the theater with, like, I was, A, the only female. It was like 3 o'clock in the
afternoon. Imagine that.
And B, the only person there under 50. Because it was 3 o'clock in the afternoon, and it was me and like five other guys in this whole theater, and they were all like.
I don't know if I like where this is going.
They were all like my dad's age. No, it didn't.
It sounds like the start of a porn.
No, it's not. But no, seriously, like I sat there in this movie. I like by the time the credits were rolling, I'm like I had to sit through the credits to get the feeling back in my legs.
That
was so
an incredible
good.
Fucking movie.
It was so good.
Yeah.
And I was like, yeah, they did Captain Kirk proud. Because to me, and I'm a giant snob, as Brendan will tell you, if it ain't Kirk, it ain't Trek to me.
Yeah, I know. We've had this, she hates Next Generation and all of that.
Mm-hmm.
Many, many, many times after many, many drinks, the Kirk versus Picard conversation starts happening.
Mm-hmm.
You know.
Many times over Crab Rangoons.
Yeah. Again, with the Crab Rangoons.
Mm-hmm.
But, you know, be that as it may, I'm looking forward to it. I think it's going to be pretty good. I'm hoping... You know, I've been waiting a long time for a good Star Wars movie.
Mm-hmm. And I think maybe that's why I've been so soured on Star Wars in general. I don't understand why people are still this obsessed with it, because I'm like, the last three movies were so shitty.
They
like,
were full of suck. Like, yes.
How is that not completely disenchanted you?
I don't know. I mean, you think it would, but I guess not.
Yeah.
Yeah. I mean, it goes back to the one and only Trek convention I went to, which was 20 years ago, and the guests were Jonathan Frakes, Commander Riker from TNG, and Marina Sirtis, who was Deanna Troi on TNG, and she flat out said during her panel, you people will watch anything with the word Star Trek before it, so I think that translates over to Wars, too. There's a Star Wars movie. Yeah, but the last three sucked. Yeah, but it's Star Wars. And we're lemmings, and we're gonna go anyway.
Yeah.
People will intentionally watch stuff they know is gonna suck. Like, people are bitching about WWE right now, and the stuff that they're doing, and I don't even watch it anymore, and I'm bitching about it.
Yeah, I don't either. I stopped.
But that's
the
thing.
Ago.
People are bitching about it and what they're doing with WrestleMania, and I said, yeah, but you know what? You're still gonna buy it.
Because it's WWE.
And they're still laughing all the way to the bank. You want to bitch about it? Don't watch it. Do something that actually affects their bottom line.
We vote with our dollars, people.
Exactly. If you think it sucks, don't spend $45 on a pay-per-view.
Mm-hmm.
And, of course, the other one, and you know, now we're going to get into my super obsession here, and pun not intended there. For some reason, even though it has wrapped filming... isn't out until next year, and that would be Batman versus Superman, Dawn of Justice.
Maybe it takes that amount of editing to make this thing good.
All I can think of is that, I mean, this thing's going to be in post-production for over a year and a half. That means way too many digital effects, way too many. And by the way, my bitching about this, I'm over Affleck. Like, I'm over the Batfleck thing. I'm just like, you know, he's a comic book fan. I saw some video of him at the San Diego Comic-Con, and Affleck has beefed up.
And you know what? The man can act.
He can act. Has he had some pretty sucky roles? Yes. And everybody's, of course, yelling Daredevil. Didn't you see Daredevil? He can't play a superhero. I'm like, he can only play
a shitty script.
Exactly. He was given a shitty script.
He did what he could with what he had.
Exactly. You know, you can't make ice cream out of horse manure, people, no matter how talented you are.
Well, you could. It just wouldn't taste very good.
It's a bit nutty. But my biggest... my biggest beef with this movie is they're trying to catch up with Marvel. Because Marvel has created this cohesive cinematic universe that has made more money than God.
But...
and they're trying to catch up by trying to cram too much into one movie.
Well, the other problem is Marvel has the secret weapon in Joss Whedon.
This is true.
No one, and I'm sorry, no one can touch Joss Whedon.
Very few. Very few are on that level, that's for sure.
Mm-hmm.
I would put him and Abrams kind of side by side.
Yes, you're right about that.
Yes.
So, okay, maybe...
I'm right. I'm glad I got that...
So, maybe...
glad I got that recorded.
So, So
he said, "I'm right." Anyway,
maybe if DC could get like Abrams on board, would help.
And they're trying to cram too much. Wonder Woman's in it. That dude from Game of Thrones is playing Aquaman for some ungodly reason. They're still trying to make Aquaman badass.
Aquaman,
it's not going to work.
Sucks.
He does. They tried to make him badass in the comics. They took his hand off, replaced it with a trident. They gave him long hair and a beard for a while. I'm like, no, he's still fucking Aquaman. But, you know, and Lex Luthor's in it, and I heard Brainiac was going to be in it, but I'm not sure.
This is going to suffer the Spider-Man 3 curse.
Yeah, they're just trying to cram too much into one movie so they can spring off into their own cinematic universe. They really should not. It's going to be such a cluttered movie. Mm-hmm. Big time.
Yep.
I think it's going to be a spectacular train wreck, but not because of Ben Affleck.
No.
He would not have been my first choice.
No.
I understand it was originally offered to Josh Brolin, and he turned it down. Now, you want a middle-aged Batman?
Yes.
Josh frickin' Brolin?
That man.
Hells yeah.
That man broods like no one else I've ever seen.
Exactly. He would have been awesome, and who the fuck turns down Batman?
Josh Brolin.
I knew you were going to. Damn it.
Hate you so very, very much.
Hate you with every tad muscle of my Confederate body.
I'm going home.
Yeah, yeah.
Anyway, we're going to move on to our next segment. Most of us, if we've dated at all, have at least one crazy ex story. There's always a bunny boiler in the past somewhere. This is Too Bad You're Crazy.
Too bad you're crazy. Too bad you're lonely as hell. So long, it could have been swell together.
So I've got a few stories this week that I found on message boards. I've got some listener-submitted ones, like I said, for some later segments this week.
I can't wait.
Yeah. Oh, boy. Anyway, so here's the first one, again, from a message board. I was dating a girl. Let's call her Ricky. We had been dating for, like, 6 or 7 months, and we were at the stage where she was, I'm going to reword this because I'm trying not to be too vulgar, performing oral sex on me. But I was never allowed to go anywhere near her vagina. Whatever, it was all good. Anyway, we were on vacation with a bunch of people, both her friends and mine, and we had separated during the day to go hang out with our own friends and do our own thing. So, whatever, we get together for dinner, we end up going to her room, and she starts going down on me. And she's got this big smile on her face, so I think all is well. Nay, nay, as he said. In this story.
Oh my god, I say nay nay.
Do you? I don't remember ever hearing you say
no,
that.
No, I don't, but John Panette does. But I say nay nay.
Oh, okay. Suddenly, I notice something is different. I feel something is wrong. There's a little bit of teeth in this BJ. So I say, whoa, whoa, easy there, I don't like teeth. And she stops. Things continue, and suddenly, there's more teeth. So I stop her and say, I'm not comfortable with this, I don't like teeth. She apologizes profusely and swears it won't happen again. Wait for it. I should have trusted my gut that she was lying. So we continue, everything is good, when suddenly I feel a draft down there. I look over and her mouth is wide open, and before I could move out of the way, chomp. You're shrieking! You're shrieking! You don't even have a penis! Naturally, I screamed bloody murder and looked down to see my heavily bleeding member go limp. So I scream at her asking what the actual fuck she was thinking, and she goes, maybe you should have spent the fucking day with me. Needless to say, she was batshit insane. Yeah, Michelle is speechless yet again, as was I, not to mention holding on to my own stuff, if you know what I mean.
Oh my god.
Now,
okay, first of all, I'm pretty passive-aggressive. I know I can be.
Yes.
It's something I'm working on. I'm not perfect.
Me too. I'm guilty of it.
I can be very passive-aggressive.
Mm-hmm.
That's
not passive-aggressive. That's aggressive.
That's aggressive. That's wicked passive-aggressive. Like, that's instead of confronting the problem and just saying,
I'll just try to bite his dick off.
Yeah, yeah, exactly. And
proportional
then,
response, people.
Yeah, and then suddenly being like, well, maybe blah, 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 like you should have known. That's wicked fucking PA. Like, come on. But not only that, but, like, I'm sorry. Like, this is just an insult to blowjobs. It just makes me so sad.
Mm-hmm. You just want to scream out, this woman does not represent us.
This woman does not represent the rest of us.
And, you know, there is almost no circumstance under which doing that is okay.
Nope.
The only one I can even think of is if she was being forced.
Yeah.
Yeah, then bite away.
Yes, seriously, go ahead.
Chow down, chomp, go for it. But otherwise, yeah. We're going to go with a friend of ours who is fond of saying, you can lick it, you can suck it, you can paint it, just don't bite it. They wrote a song about it, people. It don't matter, just don't bite it. Oh, God. That was... Yeah, when I read this story the first time, I was really hoping it wasn't going to end with, so I healed up for a couple of months, banged her one more time.
Oh, God.
I was waiting for that, because if that guy... would have gone anywhere if he did not immediately dump her after this. He should be jettisoned into outer space. Get off this planet. Deport him off the fucking planet.
There's some connection between aliens and that, but I can't make my brain make it funny right now.
Yeah, that was intentional. I couldn't make it funny either. I threw it out there for you. It's okay.
I got nothing. Sorry.
Every now and then you get a swing and a miss. It's cool.
It's true.
You got a pretty good batting average, so I'm just, yeah.
I think the fact that we both thought the same thing, though, is still pretty funny.
Yeah, imagine that.
Yeah, well, yeah, really, eh?
Yeah, I think there's an invisible USB cable sometimes connecting our brains.
Yeah, either that or some people joke that we take turns with it, with the brain.
Yeah, so we're going to move on to the next one, also found on a message board. I couldn't resist. One time, I broke up with this girl who was legitimately crazy. We broke up a few weeks before my birthday. She decided to give me a gift for my birthday, probably in an attempt to get me back. She gave me a gun rack.
I was just going to say, was it a gun rack? Oh my God! What am I going to do with a gun rack?
Somebody, this is legit. Somebody posted this on a message board.
Oh my God!
With the Wayne's World reference.
I was really, really hoping that it was a gun rack.
It is. But, yeah, he even put a gun rack. I don't even own a gun,
let alone multiple guns.
That would necessitate an entire rack.
What am I going to do with a gun rack?
I laughed my balls
that
off.
That is amazing.
I know. I was like, it was such a bait and switch.
That's
because the punchline's about halfway through. I'm thinking, oh, this is a legit story. And then I'm like, this is fucking Wayne's World.
Oh, my God. A gun rack.
We broke up. Get the net. So when I saw that, I'm like, that's going to get a laugh and a half. Out of Michelle.
That is fantastic. Oh my God.
Okay, so I threw that one just as a joke. We may need... Michelle might need a minute. She's getting the vapors. She's getting the vapors.
Wait a minute. Okay.
Oh, great. I broke her.
Okay. Anyway. Nope. Okay.
All right. And the last story in this segment. My ex-girlfriend was a crazy Christian. I don't even know where to begin. Okay, so she thought there was a second spirit named Shoe Dragon living inside her. Yeah, I know.
Oh my God.
Along with several others like Flame Ace, Silver Fang, etc. And all I could think of was, is Night Pain in there too? I want to be called by my goth name, Night Pain.
Oh God.
She thought her family were ninjas. She would pretend to cough up blood and say it was because her ninja uncle hit her in the stomach with a mace or something. I can't even.
Okay.
Hold on. You got to hear the rest of this. There's more.
Oh my God.
When we passed by a closed down Walmart, she said it was closed because her and her father were fighting in there. I'm like, what? Was there a quickening? And they had to shut down the whole Walmart? And much more that I repressed. She was crazy, but what can I say? I was bored. Also, I am now gay.
Wow.
I really hope that last line is true.
Yeah.
Because I gotta tell you, if I met this crazy bitch, I would hold my breath until I turned gay.
I can't even joke about the whole gay thing.
Well, no, you know what I'm saying.
No, I know.
It's just like, okay.
Yeah.
I'm not saying it's certainly to be prejudicial. It's just kind of like, maybe it's just easier on the other side of the fence. Maybe there's less crazy.
No, it just reinforces the idea that gay is a choice.
No, that's not what I meant at all.
No, I realize.
Of course.
You know. Anyway, no, when you were talking about all the other, all I could think of was like, well, we would, except for Lister Fiend. And pillow pants.
Oh, from Clerks 2.
Clerks 2. Lister Fiend and pillow pants.
Yeah. Flame Ace.
Oh,
I'm
God.
Like, okay, Silver Fang, they could have stolen from the role-playing game that we used to play. But but Flame Ace? That sounds like a third-string Marvel character.
Oh, my God. Night Pain.
But how do you go from, okay, we're crazy Christians and we're ninjas?
Mm-hmm.
That is a combination I never, ever want to see. I don't want to see a crazy Christian ninja.
And my body's full of spirit dragons. That's very not Christian.
Yeah, Yes, exactly. How could you be a crazy Christian and believe in that?
Not part of Christian lore.
Not even a little.
No.
Oh my God.
I don't know if that's part of anything.
I don't know.
I don't think so.
Yeah. That was... the pretending to cough up blood thing. I just... How does one do that? Do you just eat a bunch of sweet and sour chicken and...
Or just like the, or the blood capsules, like the fake blood capsules or something. Like, really?
Yeah. Because, well,
I've seen people go to some pretty extreme lengths, things like that, you know, faking injuries and faking things for like...
Don't they call that like Munchausen syndrome or something?
Munchausen syndrome.
Munchausen. I'm close.
Baron Munchausen.
Yes.
But I've seen people faking, you know, injuries and pain and stuff like to get...
Attention.
Get attention or narcotics.
Oh, yeah. Well, I've seen that. Yeah.
But just for fuck's sake, for no
Night
reason.
Pain needs some Percocets.
Yeah, really. No, I mean, I've seen people like spiking their urine with blood to fake a kidney stone to get pain meds, like pricking their finger and I saw a story of people like deliberately burning themselves repeatedly just to go in and say, "I burned myself. I need pain medication." Like, but this actually kind of goes beyond the crazy I've seen.
Yeah. One step beyond, that's for sure.
Wow, we're Christians and we're ninjas and my body's full of spirit dragons.
But I really wanted to fuck her.
Yeah, they're like, I thought I really didn't have an out because, like, I screwed somebody who's basically a criminal. Mm-hmm. But, like, that's really, like, there's no excuse for that.
None. Zero.
None.
Run the fuck away.
Mm-hmm.
Run fast, run far.
Mm-hmm.
I want to apologize for my coughing. I have a little tickle in my throat, so
that's fighter. That is fight or flight, and nowhere should fuck be in there.
Yeah, no. Fight or flight, you know, you kind of inadvertently coined fight, flight, or fuck,
mm-hmm.
but there should be no fuck there. Not a fuck should be given in any respect.
Zero fucks were given that day.
Yes. So, moving right along, most of us have at least one really good drinking story. Michelle and I have several.
Oh, wow.
And all the hilarity that ensues after imbibing way too much alcohol, this segment is, of course, called Drink 'em Down.
So I drink 'em down, babe. One after the other, yes, I drink 'em down.
So we're getting our first listener-submitted stories in this week. Thank you for everybody who sent in stories. If you don't hear yours this week, it will be in there somewhere. I have yet to have one submitted to me that I would turn away. That's for
mm-hmm.
sure. So we're going to start off with this one. I've only got two this week because these are kind of long.
Yeah.
So we're going to go right into the first one. I was 18, and my friend and I were visiting my older friend who had his own apartment. We brought a coworker with us. The coworker was really cute, and we decided that she was a perfect match for the host of the party. We had spent the night drinking mass quantities of Aftershock. Do they still make Aftershock?
I think they do.
Do they? Because I haven't had Aftershock since my early 20s, I don't think.
Yeah, I think I was there that night that we had it.
Yeah, probably.
Because I think we were switching off cinnamon and Aftershock or something.
Goldschlager, I think, maybe, was in there somewhere. I did have Goldschlager with you, I think, at one point. But
anyway, we digress. Yeah, we digress.
So, okay, so they're drinking mass quantities of Aftershock. Two of the people at the party were lightweights and went to bed early in the host's bed. Later in the evening, everyone started to pass out in various places around the apartment. Our coworker, in her drunken haze, threw up all over the edge of the couch and then stumbled her way into what she thought was a bathroom. This is kind of evocative of Al's story last mm-hmm. week, the closet peeing incident, but this is way worse. So into what she thought was a bathroom. She went into the host's bedroom where the lightweights were sleeping. She pulled down her pants and sat in the host's computer chair. She then proceeded to shit and piss in the chair.
Oh my God.
She then proceeded to pull up her pants and sit back in the chair. Okay, I have to stop there for a second. Now, realize, even she's shitting in the chair, there's nowhere for it to go, so it is just smearing all over everything, including herself. I apologize for how gross this is, folks, but it is what it is.
Uh-huh.
So she sits back in the chair with her pants on, so now she is dirty all over the place with various bodily excretions. Apparently, she wanted to sleep in the bed, so she crawled into bed with the lightweights who were sleeping there, covered in urine and feces. One of the people in the bed woke up when she felt someone in the bed and was overwhelmed by the stench.
Well, yeah.
He turned on the light to see a shit-covered girl trying to cuddle with him and his girlfriend. This should never happen.
Never!
Oh, God. The host hears screaming coming from the bedroom and enters to see three people now covered in shit in his bed. So I'm sure his first thought is some sort of scatological threesome is going on here.
Oh.
The host walks my coworker into the bathroom, turns on the shower, and makes her stand in the shower fully clothed, then made her strip to wash the shit off her body. After she was cleaned up, he gave her a t-shirt and boxers and left her to sleep on the couch. Now, apparently this listener is very attentive, because remember how I was complaining about a couple of stories that there was no aftermath? I wanted to know what happened after?
Yeah.
This listener included the aftermath and even labeled it the aftermath. Very convenient.
Nice.
The next morning, he woke her up and told her she needed to leave. She didn't understand why. Okay, somebody blacked out.
Yes.
He told her to go in the bathroom and look at her clothes in the shower. There was silence in the bathroom for the next 20 minutes. Suddenly, there is a flurry of activity, and she runs out of the bathroom, grabs her bag, and runs out the door without a word.
Yeah.
I cannot imagine the level of mortified this woman must have been.
I know.
The next day, we get to work, not sure what we plan to say to her, to find out she has quit her job, never to be heard from again.
Wow. That's...
I would run the fuck away, too, I think, if I did that.
I don't know.
I mean, I've done some dopey stuff when I've been drunk, but nothing even in the same time zone.
No.
That... Yeah.
Mm-mm.
That is... I can't decide if this is a funny story or not. It's like,
I know,
it's... a sick part of me wants to laugh, but I mean, this person was so mortified the next day that she quit her job and disappeared.
Yeah. I'm moving to a different town, man. Like, wow.
Yeah, that's a lot of wow.
That, yeah.
Big bucket of wow.
Wow.
Oh, my God.
Oh, yeah.
Anyway, this ought to be good because it's from the same listener. Same apartment, different party. Remind me never to go to this place. Mm-hmm. Ever, ever, ever.
Yeah.
A group of four people and I are standing in the roommate's bedroom. The geniuses decide that they want to do flaming shots.
Oh, no.
Try never to do this.
Yeah.
I wasn't drinking, but...
drinking and fire together.
Oh, wait for it.
Oh.
I wasn't drinking. I was the designated driver, but I had to watch the show. Like you do.
Like you do.
Being young and stupid, they don't realize that... to do a flaming shot, you light the drink and blow out the flame before you drink it.
No!
Yes.
No!
They are drinking the shots while they are still on fire.
No!
Talk about should be deported from the fucking planet.
No.
Unless they were already wrecked, and even then.
Yeah.
They proceed to go around in a circle doing these shots. It's the roommate's turn to complete the shot.
Yeah.
Alcohol runs across his cheek, but since the alcohol is on fire, so is his cheek and his hair.
Oh, no!
Not remembering what we all learned in elementary school, that you need to stop, drop, and roll, he starts to flail around trying to put it out. As he flails, the left side of his head is engulfed in flames.
I'm on fire!
His name was Harvey Dent. No, anyway. Oh. I'm sorry. No, I threw that in there.
Oh.
Great. A Phantom of the Bloody Opera. Anyway, another friend who was home on leave from the army grabs a blanket and throws it over his head and then proceeds to kick him in the head with his steel-toed army boots to put him out.
Wow.
He's on fire. Let's beat the fuck out of him.
That's like insult to injury right
Big
there.
Time. Okay, yeah. And once again, the aftermath.
Nice!
Flame Boy runs into the shower trying to stop the burning. Being the designated driver, it was my job to drive him to the hospital.
Oh.
While driving him, I look over at him and see something dripping from his ear.
No!
I ask what it is, and the guy said... he told me, I don't want to know. His skin had melted. At the hospital, I hid while he explained to the triage nurse why half of his hair was gone and his ear was melting off his head.
Wow, that's gross.
That is... when some of you is seeping through your fingers, you've gone too far.
Yeah.
I genuinely hope this did have a down ending, but I hope it was just his ear that melted, because they can make an ear, you know, yeah. prosthetic ear. I'm like, did this guy get, like, legitimately disfigured by this? No. Should I have not made the Harvey Dent joke? I don't know. Mm. So if he was, please forgive me. I don't know. I have no way of finding out.
Mm-mm.
But yeah.
Mm.
That tops the frickin' kitty litter story.
Mm-hmm.
Just in sheer magnitude.
Yeah.
Yeah. Yikes.
Oh, wow. I yeah.
Don't I'm that anymore.
I'm with you. I kind of got nothing. Like.
Yeah. It had kind of a downer ending. Yeah. I apologize. So, to cleanse the palate, let's move on. Let's move on to the next segment. Now, most of us have some kind of sex story. Either the sex is bad, or, you know, it's just a really fucked up situation. We call it bad sex.
I just had sex and it was so bad. I'm glad that it's over, cause the bad sex was so bad. Yeah, I just had bad sex.
So here we have another listener submitted story. You cannot make this shit up.
No.
You really can't. Like, I have a pretty demented imagination, as you know.
Mm-hmm.
And even I would have trouble coming up with this one. This is from a woman. She said, my ex, who I will refer to as Tom, not his real name, was into various kinky behavior, including but not limited to cross-dressing, bondage, and auto-restraint. I'm not even sure I know what auto-restraint is. Is that when you simply restrain oneself?
I guess so.
I guess. At one point, actually, I think this was shortly after he and I had broken up, also of note in this story, is that this ex still lived in the basement of his grandparents' house. This is not going to end well.
No.
So one day, after his grandparents had just left for a long weekend out of state, Tom decided to set a little scene for himself. He changed into a skirt and blouse, set up a short lead and a collar locked to the headboard of his bed/futon, attached ankle cuffs to the footboard, and then put the key in a time release sort of thing that would eventually provide access to him so that he could release himself from the restraints. Essentially, the key was on top of a Dixie cup, on the bottom of which had been cut out, which was filled with water, then frozen. Theoretically, the ice would melt down until it fell from the cup above him, and the key would drop so that he could unlock all the locks. I'm going to stop here. This is way too much fucking work.
Yeah. Look,
I'm not judging anybody. Whatever you're into, you're into. Whatever gets you through the night, as long as you're not killing people or messing around with kids, I don't care. Have at it.
Right.
Whatever consenting adults decide to do with each other or themselves, whatever you want. But this is just, I don't have this kind of energy anymore. This guy must have been pretty young.
I know, he must have been really, like, bored.
Yeah, this is like a fetishistic MacGyver. He's just, like, building shit, you know? Anyway.
Oh, my God.
Well, he strapped himself down with only enough movement available so that he could reach his crotch. Okay, so this is a masturbation thing, fine.
Yeah, well, yeah, this is, I guess, the auto-restraint
thing. Yeah. After quite some time, the ice finally melted and fell from the cup above, but the key got stuck.
Oh, God!
At this point, Tom is freaking out, well, like you do.
I mean, honestly, I would have already lost interest at the whole, all the work it would take just... I think even just to get the skirt and blouse on, I mean, A, I just don't like skirts, and it's just, getting dressed up is way too much effort as it is. It's like, no, like, if it's just you, and you're just, like, why?
Yeah, whatever.
Way too much effort. I don't even like things that take more than 3 ingredients to cook, like, let alone all that.
Well, there's a lot more than 3 ingredients in this scenario, that's for sure.
Way too much work. I've already lost interest. Mm. Like, forget it. That's so not worth it.
So anyway, at this point, he's freaking out that, A, no one was home and no one was expected to be home for days, so he was stuck.
Oh, no.
B, once someone got home, it was likely to be his grandparents. And C, he had no real way to change clothes or explain this scene if someone did find him. No, you don't. You're pretty much screwed at this point.
Yeah, pretty much.
He ended up ripping apart the rubber... He ended up ripping apart the rubber collar to free his torso. He then tipped the bed sideways, crawled, dragging the bed behind him until he could reach his boken, which is a wooden practice sword.
Yes.
He then used the boken to try to prop himself up so that he could right the bed and then knock the cup until... I can't even picture this in my head, and I have a great imagination. I can't even envision this. Until the key fell, after calming down and presumably smoking a few cigarettes, his first course of action was to then call me and relate the story. The first words out of my mouth were, quote, "You're a dumbass."
Yeah.
That phrase was repeated throughout the conversation. Tom and I are still friends, and he still refers to that incident, and I still call him a dumbass.
Yep.
It's way too much work, way too much risk involved.
Yes!
You know, just...
See, I think I would have just given up and let my grandparents find me.
Just... No, because they would drop dead. I mean, seriously.
Well, either way, they wouldn't tell anyone.
And she's saying that, and her grandparents live next door.
They do.
Jesus.
Are you kidding? My grandparents are so much hardier than that.
That's true. Yeah, but I think that might be pushing it even for them.
My Nana's going to be at my funeral.
Yeah, that's true. Oh, she'll hang in there.
Oh, absolutely.
Anyway, so I found a couple more on a... On, oddly enough, a swingers message board.
Yeah.
So these are people, you know, who, you know, they do the couple swapping and all that.
Yeah, yeah.
Whatever. Hey, whatever does it for you, folks. Anyway, so here's this woman. My husband and I are in the swinger lifestyle, and we frequent a local club that caters to that crowd. There are usually private, quote, playrooms set up for people who hit it off and want to have some fun. My husband and I were chatting up this couple when a woman emerged from one of the playrooms and made her way to the other side of the club. Moments later, a man came out of the playroom, naked as the day he was born. We were all trying not to look because this is awkward even for a swingers club. He wandered around looking confused for a bit, and then it happened. He began walking up to every female in the room, including myself, holding his penis in his hand and simply asking, "Want some?"
Can I offer you some dick?
That's pretty much what he's doing.
How about some dick?
Thank you, Chris Rock. It was simultaneously uncomfortable and hysterical. He then wandered over to the other side of the club and was leaning on the bar, still balls naked. The manager asked him to leave shortly after that.
Yeah.
A couple days later, my husband came into the bedroom after a shower, grabbed his junk, and said, "Want some?" I laughed so hard I almost peed myself.
Yeah.
Okay, folks, look. You know, I've had friends that have been in the swinger lifestyle, and, you know, there are some events that are just, like, wanton orgies, just naked people grasping at whatever, but a lot of the clubs... But a lot of the clubs, I mean, people aren't necessarily doing stuff in public, or they're not even there to screw around, they're just there to flirt or whatever. It's not, you know, what people think it is. But that's fucked up, even for a swingers event.
Yeah.
You don't just, you know, walk up and...
A bunch of strangers would be like, "Hey, want some?
Want some dick?" You know, yeah, you don't just... Yeah.
Can I interest you in some dick?
Yeah, just... And my first... Okay, first of all, I hope to God this guy was completely wrecked. Because either that or he is the dumbest human being walking the face of the earth. Did he think that was going to work?
No.
You know, he's going to walk up to some woman with his dick in his hand, say, "Want some?" And some woman's going to go, "Ah." You know, it's... You know, and no. No, that's not going to work. But I like the husband's callback to it. That,
yeah, exactly.
Those are the kind of things that's worth enduring just for the private joke.
Right, right. No, if it was like a partner, like a long-term somebody that I was familiar with, and they did that, I'd be like, yeah, that would work.
But random naked dude walking out of a playroom. Naked,
well, it would also depend on how hot he was, I guess, but...
No. Now we're back to it again. I just really wanted to fuck him.
Yeah, you know.
So you'd overlook the weakest opening line ever, "Here's my dick, want some," you know?
Because, like I said, in a backward way, that sort of almost circles back around to just being kind of awesome. Like the jigglypuff.
Especially if you were into the swinger lifestyle, you're less likely to be shocked. I mean, if you're at the corner pub and somebody does that, that's...
No, in an environment...
I got a word for that. Illegal.
In an environment like that, though, where
people are a bit more sexually...
More open.
Open, thank you. They're I was trying to find open. The right word.
And, like, you know, there's a bit more of an expectation in that direction that might not be so bad. Like, that would actually be kind of, like, that would, like, that might circle back from being terrible into being kind of awesome.
It's funny how that happens, that something can be so ridiculous that it circles all the way back around and becomes awesome.
Yeah, yeah.
I don't know if that works. I mean, I'm not the least bit homophobic, but that would make me a little uncomfortable.
Well, yeah.
But, you know, if you think about it, this woman's husband could have totally turned it around on him.
And been like,
could have been like, I would. Hello, sailor. You know, or something like that.
Yeah, yeah.
But then that could have backfired on him.
Because they could have called the bluff. And
exactly. Or what if the guy was bi, you know, and then he would have been kind of stuck.
Like I said,
Yeah, exactly. So that's, yeah.
That type of, but it's always a gamble.
Yes.
Well, anytime you put yourself out there for sex, it's a gamble.
True. Oh, yeah, that's true.
Not only a gamble of, are they going to say yes or no, but it's a gamble of, if they say yes, is that even going to end up being a good thing?
Right.
As we're demonstrating.
Yes. Well, I've got a couple of repeatedly. Stories about that. Yeah. Anyway. Yeah. So anyway, also from the same message board, the swingers message board that I found these on. My God. My wife and I were at a swingers event at a local bar. I was sitting on the couch while my wife was in front of me pleasuring me. While this was going on, a couple that we knew from these events passed us to go out for a smoke. There were two 20-something girls with them. As they passed, they all cheered and high-fived me. Later on, I found out the two girls with them were their daughter/stepdaughter and her girlfriend. So basically, I got high-fived by two generations of swingers, two of which were hot lesbians.
Again,
this is awesome.
This circles back into awesome.
I shouldn't even have put this in a segment called Bad Sex because, okay, it's a little weird that if you're a married couple, you know, and it's, I don't know whose daughter it was and whose stepdaughter it was in that equation.
Yeah, and there's just this.
You don't bring, even if they're of age, which I assume they wouldn't have been let in.
Yeah.
You don't bring your kids to the swingers club with you, do you?
I know. There's like this generational barrier when it comes to openness about sex. Parents don't want to know what their kids are doing. Kids do not want to know what their parents are doing. But, it's just creepy.
But there they are.
But there they are.
That's that aspect of it is weird.
I mean, I've always thought that the whole, like, closedness between generations is a little puritanical.
It is. I can see that. You know, and it's better to be open with your kids so they know certain things.
Yeah. And it's also way better not to deny your kids their sexuality, either.
Well, no, true. But I'm just saying...
Yeah, yeah. It's not something you talk about at the dinner table.
No, granted. Certainly not.
But,
you know?
Yeah, I don't think there should be this closedness where, like, everyone puts on blinders and, like, no one in this family is having sex. Like, I hate that.
Then how did we get here?
Yeah, exactly. Like, I hate that.
Yeah. Oh, my God. Anyway, we have one final segment for this week. We were talking earlier about how some people should just be deported from the planet, and this is a whole bunch of people who need to be deported from the planet because they're just fucking stupid. This segment is called Stupid People.
Stupid people everywhere. Stupid people got stupid hair. Stupid people, they don't care because they're stupid, 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 stupid.
So this first one was from a message board that's a bunch of customer service calls. Like people who've worked in, you know, customer service and gotten those calls.
The land of the I don't know. Seriously.
I started, you know, in my real job in customer service and I moved up a little bit. So I'm not really dealing with backwards ass fucks calling me, asking me for stupid shit.
Oh my God.
But I can certainly relate to this. So here's the caller. Here's the call.
Seriously, call centers are like just this unbelievable cross section of humanity.
Oh yeah. I mean, working in a call center, I mean, these stories, they kind of make their own gravy. It's just like, these things are going to happen.
Oh my God.
You know what
yeah,
I mean? It's
totally.
It's bound to happen.
Yeah.
So here's the call. Me. Let me take a look at your account. Just give me one moment to call. Gets cut off. Caller. My internet's busted. Me. I'm sorry to hear that, ma'am. It'll just take one moment. Ah, here we go. It seems that your account has not been paid for 3 months, so we've suspended your... Caller. Why is my internet shut off? Me. Okay, keep in mind, she just told this person why. Ma'am, I can understand your frustration, but due to non-payment, we've suspended your account. However, if you would like to make a credit card payment over the phone, I can go ahead and she gets cut off again. Caller, I don't have a credit card. Why is my internet not working? Ma'am, I'm sorry, but I can't turn you back on until a portion of the balance is paid off. If you're able to make a partial payment, cut off again. Turn me back on. I need my internet. In a sudden quiet voice, this woman says, Jesus wouldn't have turned me off. Now, I've heard the song Jesus Take the Wheel, but never Jesus Turn on My Wi-Fi. The good Lord reset my router. No.
No, 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 no.
Okay, it goes on. Me, staring, startled blink. Pardon, ma'am? Caller, gaining steam. I said Jesus wouldn't have turned me off. I don't have the money to pay for this, and he wouldn't have shut me off. Me. I do apologize, ma'am, but I don't see where this is relevant to your overdue bill. Caller. Jesus loved everyone, and he would have given me free internet. I can't. I can't even deal with this. But are you ready for this? You're going to love this.
Okay.
Okay. Me, the customer service person, responds. Ma'am, do you remember biblical quotes? Wasn't it Jesus himself who said, render unto Caesar that which is Caesar's, and render unto God that which is God's? Pwned!
Damn! Oh my
that is
God!
Such uber pwnage.
Totally.
Caller, silence. Me, anyway, I cannot turn your internet back on until you've made a payment. Caller, let me speak to your manager. Me, my pleasure. This would have been funny without that. But the very fact that this woman got owned with a Bible quote.
So owned.
And when I read that, my jaw dropped. I was like, it does say that in the Bible.
It does.
Yeah.
I wouldn't have been able to think of that on the spot.
No, but holy shit. See, even Jesus would have made you pay your bill first. Mm-hmm. And then he would have forgiven you.
Yes.
Anyway. Mm. Oh, boy. All right,
wow.
So here's another stupid criminal story. I'm finding a ton of these.
Yeah.
A man called the New York Police Department 6 times hoping to find a prostitute. Like you do.
Like you do.
Clearly, he had the wrong number. Not believing, apparently, the female dispatcher who kept telling him he was reaching the police department... who kept hanging up on him. So 6 times this woman says, you're reaching the NYPD. And he's calling back.
Looking for a hooker.
On the 6th call, the police had enough and arranged to meet him at a hotel. He then only had 1 more phone call he could make, and it wasn't for a prostitute.
Wow.
You just... Okay.
I'm hearing strains of The Entertainer in the background.
Mm-hmm.
The Sting.
Oh, God. I was like, what the hell are you talking about? Oh, but just, wow. You know, calling a wrong number. Fine. And, you know, asking for a hooker. You're lucky they gave you 5 chances.
And didn't arrest you right away.
Right away. This isn't some dinky...
For soliciting prostitution, which is illegal!
Exactly. And this isn't some dinky small town police department. This is the
NYPD!
That means knock your punk ass down! That's right out of Men in Black. I had to throw that in there.
Totally.
But, yeah. And they gave him 5 chances. You show me a New York cop who's going to give you 5 chances to get away with anything. That is not easy to find. This guy deserved anything that happened to him.
Mm-hmm.
I mean, did he just keep forgetting he had already called this number and they had told him this is not Rent-A-Hooker, this is the NYPD?
Was he super wasted?
I hope so. If he wasn't wasted, get him off the planet.
Yeah, you're out.
I think I keep saying that this week, and I'm just like, the aliens won't come, so I think we should just jettison people into outer space and let them deal with it.
Yeah.
Or maybe as a warning, no, don't come here. Yeah. This is what we produce.
Yeah, seriously. You know? Oh, man.
And finally this week, I almost want to call shenanigans on this story because I cannot believe, even after what I just read, that any human being could be this stupid.
Yeah.
This, oh boy. I mean, some people can be so stupid, it's just like, you know, from an evolutionary standpoint, you're like, this guy should never have been allowed to crawl down from the trees. This guy should have never left the fucking ocean, okay?
Oh,
this
wow.
is that bad. In Ohio, an unidentified man in his late 20s walked into a police station with a 9-inch wire protruding from his forehead and calmly asked the officers to give him an x-ray to help him find his brain, which he claimed had been stolen.
Obviously.
Yeah. My first question, believe it or not, was why did this guy think the police would have an x-ray machine? Wouldn't you go to the hospital for that?
Because his brain was stolen.
Oh. So he didn't think of that.
He didn't think of that.
But he thought to go to the police station. What did he think that with? There's no way out of this.
With the wire in his head.
This is like a freaking like a robberous circle.
The wire in his head told him, go to the police. That's perfect.
If if The Wire was talking, that's something else entirely.
Well, it probably was because
we're not even done with this story yet.
Because his brain had been stolen.
Police were shocked to learn the man had drilled a 6-inch deep hole in his skull with a Black & Decker power drill and had stuck the wire in to try to find the missing brain. Question number one. You think your brain has been stolen. First of all, you're on something.
Mm-hmm.
You are on something. Like super ultra mega bath salts, I don't know.
Yeah.
But something. But your brain resides in your head. If you think it's missing, why would you check your head?
Because you don't have a brain. You're not thinking that it's not going to be there.
If I only had a brain.
Yeah. You know, seriously, maybe
but if it was stolen, what did he think it was stolen with?
I don't know.
Like, he thought his brain had been stolen, but if there's no brain, how did he think of that? We could go on like this all day.
Well, we've already agreed this is not logical, Captain. No.
It's life, Jim, but not as we know it.
Yes! Yes!
Fascinating.
Yeah, really.
No, even Kirk would have run the fuck away from this guy.
Yeah, I think so.
This is why Starfleet doesn't come.
Yeah, this is why we don't...
Even Spock's like, fuck that.
Why we haven't had first contact yet?
Yeah, exactly.
Yeah.
Because
yeah.
We're out of our Vulcan minds.
Yeah, well, like when you said he didn't make it out of the ocean, that reminded me of the only next-gen quote that I ever actually like.
Mm-hmm.
Imagine it, Picard. All the life on this planet you've ever known started with this puddle
of goo. He should never have left the goo.
Oh, wow.
He should have stayed goo. I think he probably did.
Yeah. Or, like you said, he's super mega on something.
Yes.
Either way, this person is obviously very, very ill. And it's very sad.
Yeah. I just...
Yeah. Drilled a hole in his own...
Did he ever find it? How did this guy not lobotomize himself? 6 inches!
He probably did.
Maybe that's why he thought... But no, he was already fucked up enough to think his brain was stolen before he drilled the hole to go looking for it. There are some serious missing details.
Yeah.
I would not have wanted to be the cop.
Yeah.
Because they don't get paid enough to deal with shit like this.
No.
Not even close.
No. No, you that know? That's, yeah.
I mean, I used to watch that show Cops. I've seen them have to wrangle pythons that have gotten out of their pens.
I think they're going to be some domestic disturbances.
And then a domestic disturbance where they realize that the couple is arguing in Klingon.
Mm.
Yeah.
That really happened, didn't it?
Yes, it did. I did not make that up.
I am unsurprised.
Yeah.
Wait, was it us?
It was not us.
Oh.
Gustach Baloa? I'm sorry. Anyway.
Kia tojoka.
Oh my god, we just spoke Klingon.
I totally did. That's the only phrase I know in Klingon. Yeah. The only one.
And we're not going to translate it because it's already sad. Anyway.
It's already wicked
before
sad.
Before we get any more sad and pathetic, we're going to wrap this up for this week. Thank you for listening. If you like what you hear, please join our Facebook group. Listen to us on SoundCloud and on YouTube on the Crazed Weasel YouTube channel. This, my friends, is truly why the aliens don't come. This podcast is the property of Brendan Millett, all rights reserved. All music and audio clips used in this podcast are the property of their respective copyright owners. This podcast was hosted by Brendan Millett and Michelle Poitras. Opening theme composed and performed by Chris Lott. Official logo by Michael Magario at Pixel Pusher Studio. If you've enjoyed this podcast, join our Facebook group at facebook.com/groups/thisiswhythealiensdon'tcome, all one word.